Great pleasure to name this ship George William Gordon. May God bless her and all who sail on her. It gives me great pleasure to name this ship Alexander Bustamante. May God bless her and all who sail on her.
Let us pray and bless this ship in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Has now been officially named. However, Alexander Bustamante has not yet been commissioned. Therefore, she has not yet been given the designation HMJS before her name. The commissioning of a ship refers to her being officially placed into active service. The commissioning date also represents the birth date of a ship, the date from which its service is measured. The Chief of Defense Staff issues a signed warrant or commissioning order to the commanding officer of a ship, which stipulates the manner in which the captain and crew are to carry out their duties. The Brigade Commander, Maritime, Air, and Cyber Command, Brigadier Roger Williams, will read the commissioning order. On completion, the ship will hoist the commissioning pennant on the main mast, signaling that the vessel has been officially commissioned and has now been given the designation of Her Majesty's Jamaica Ship, or HMJS.
Commissioning order by Lieutenant General Rocky Mead, Chief of Defense Staff, to Lieutenant Senior Grade Marlon McHugh, Ship Captain. The Defense Board has directed that Her Majesty's Jamaica Ship, Alexander Bustamante, is to be commissioned at Port Royal on the 30th of December 2021. You are to proceed forthwith to commission her for her general service. Her Majesty's Jamaica Ship, Alexander Bustamante, on commissioning, will be under my full command. You are to bring to my immediate notice to the Commander, Maritime Air and Cyber Command, anything which gives you cause for dissatisfaction with the ship or any part of her or any other matters of importance, in particular those relating to the welfare be upon the ship and the personnel hereby entrusted to your command, and may your joint endeavors to uphold the high traditions of the Jamaica Defense Force in the service of your nation meet with success and happiness. Given this day under my hand, the 30th day of December 2021. Hoist the commissioning pennant.
If you look towards the mast of the ship, you will see the commissioning pennant being hoisted. It is worn at the main mast or other location where it will fly clear continuously throughout the ship's commission. The masthead pennant is across a St. George in the hoist and a white fly. The commissioning pennant is flown continuously in every ship and shore establishment in commission in Her Majesty's service.
Hoist the flag!
If you look towards the bow of the ship, you will see the jack being hoisted. The jack is flown on the jack staff of a commissioned vessel. The jack is being hoisted by ordinary seaman O'Neill Spencer, who has been serving in the Jamaica Defense Force for 3 years.
Very well. This company will remove headdress. Remove headdress.
Ladies and gentlemen, Her Majesty's Jamaica Ship, Alexander Bustamante.
This company. Stand up. East. Stand.
You may be seated. We have now completed the commissioning ceremony, and we will now commence the commissioning service.
Brothers, seeing that in the course of our duty we shall meet with difficulties and danger, and that we cannot be faithful to the high trust placed in us without the help of Almighty God, we are met together to pray for his blessing upon the ship and all who serve in her, that we may sail under his good providence and protection for the security of our country Jamaica and the Commonwealth of Nations, and to offer our work and service for his greater honor and glory. I call upon you to pray for God's blessing on this ship. May God the Father bless her. May Jesus Christ bless her. May the Holy Spirit bless her. What do ye fear, seeing that God the Father is with you? What do ye fear, seeing that Jesus the Son is with you? What do ye fear, seeing that God the Holy Spirit is with you?
Please stand.
And when he was entered into a ship, his disciples followed him, and behold, there arose a great tempest in the sea, insomuch that the ship was covered with the waves, but he was asleep. And his disciples came to him and awoke him, saying, Lord, save us, we perish. And he said unto them, Why are ye fearful, O ye of little faith? Then he arose and rebuked the wind and the sea, and there was a great calm. But the men marveled, saying, What manner of man is this, that even the wind and the sea obey him?
Let us all pray together. Teach us, good Lord, to serve you as you deserve, to give and not count the cost, to fight and not heed the wounds, to toil and not to seek for rest, to labor and not to ask for any reward, save that of knowing we do your will, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Until day and night come to an end, receive into your almighty and most gracious protection us, your servants, and the ship in which we serve. Preserve us from the dangers of the sea and air, and from the violence of the enemy, that we may be a safeguard and a security for all who travel upon the seas upon their lawful occasion, that the inhabitants of our island may in peace and quietness serve you, our God, that we may return in safety to enjoy the blessing of the land with the fruits of our labors, and with a thankful remembrance of your mercies to praise and honor you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And in our Christ has taught us, so we pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now, my brothers and sisters, go forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honor all persons. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you all, even evermore. Amen.
Each company will replace edges. Replace edges.
The ceremonial procedures of a naval group might be described as the visible manifestations of its customs and its traditions. Jamaican naval ceremonial procedures evolve from established practices and are in accordance with the standard procedures of Commonwealth nations. The bonds of sailors worldwide often extend beyond national boundaries. Therefore, there is similarity in the naval customs of most nations. Herein lies the basis for the courteous conduct of ships at sea and a common understanding of what constitutes the paying of marks of respect between vessels at sea. Naval establishments observe evening colors or sunset on board commission units daily at the precise time of sunset for that day. On special occasions, such as today, a ceremonial sunset ceremony is carried out, in which the ceremony takes place at a stipulated time outside of actual sunset. In such cases, the ceremony will be musically accompanied by the band. At 5 minutes to sunset, the petty officer of the day will indicate to the color officer. At this point, the preparatory pennant will be hoisted, indicating that the parade will be on standby to execute the actions for the evolution. It is now 5 minutes to sunset. At 1 minute to sunset, the petty officer of the day will indicate to the officer. At this point, the parade will be called to attention. It is now 1 minute to sunset.
1 minute to sunset, sir!
Very well. Fire! Fire! Now!
At the report of sunset, the bosun's call or whistle will be sounded. The preparatory pennant will be dipped, signaling the commencement of the final act of the ceremony, the lowering of the ensign. It is now sunset. Please stand.
Sunset!
Start! Very well. Right, the
Thank you. Please be seated. As we mark the conclusion of the sunset ceremony, ladies and gentlemen, we thank you for sharing with us in this historic occasion the welcoming of Her Majesty's Jamaica ship, Alexander Bustamante, to the fleet. HMJS Alexander Bustamante, being the latest addition to the fleet, arrived at HMJS Cagre on the 5th of August 2021. It will operate with a crew of 17 and will deploy as part of the 2nd District Sailor Coast Guard fleet. Each of the OPVs, or offshore patrol vessels here named today, have significantly bolstered the Coast Guard's capability to monitor and safeguard the borders of the country. Protecting Jamaica's maritime borders is imperative for national security and sustainable development. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the naming and commissioning ceremony, Her Majesty's Jamaica ships. Our distinguished guests will now be invited to tour the vessel.
Ceremony. Yes. Yeah. 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 Ye